Hello guys, it's Angelina and Dima here. What's up? Today's episode we continue our series dedicated to our fellow beginner hikers and backpackers. In this video we want to share beginner hiker clothing list from Decathlon. We're going to cover clothing and shoes, both for men and women, and narrow your choice down to the items that we tested, and they proved to be comfortable and good quality.
We've been using the Decathlon store for more than 6 years now, and when we were beginners we bought everything there. But we also vividly remember being overwhelmed and intimidated by the many choices available on the market. So we know well that there may be certain difficulties when you are starting out. Proper, comfortable clothing is essential for hiking. And perhaps some don't think about it and go hiking in simple, casual clothes. And in our opinion, this is not quite correct. And we're sure if you go hiking wearing clothes designed for this at least once, you will no longer want to continue wearing casual clothes.
So we begin our list with underwear. That is the first thing you need on a hike. You may underestimate the importance of it. And even more so, if you don't wear the right pants, your hike may fail.
And well, maybe it's not that bad, but the comfy pants are still very, very important.
We prefer the Challenger brand. They are one of the best. We like boxer type for men and bikini type for women. They're easy to wash and don't feel tight on you when you move, having a nice stretchy elastic. Another important characteristic is that the pants don't have to rub your skin when you sweat a lot on a hike. They fit well, don't restrict the movements, and dry very fast. So to us they perform better than others, and those are our go-to model. For the bra, I prefer the Challenger Classic running bra and find it quite nice and comfortable as it has the non-wired cups, flat seams and padded straps. It can be a bit hot to wear in warm conditions, otherwise a great budget option. Next up is the t-shirt. This is what we clearly underestimated on our first trips. We started hiking in simple cut-on t-shirts and suffered quite a bit. We recommend the Quechua MH 500 line of t-shirts, both for men and women. They come in many different colors and prints to suit your taste. It is a great option to feel the fundamental difference from simple cotton t-shirts. It is made of synthetic material that dries very quickly. So you don't walk around wet for many hours when sweating, that is the case with cotton t-shirts. It is easy to wash. We have tested those t-shirts in more than one season of hiking and they proved to be quite resistant to wiping and stretching. And we often wear them even when not on a hike. Another even more budget line we can recommend is the Quechua MH 100. They have slightly different fabric, but is similarly comfortable to wear and very light. They're available in different colors too. And we actually quite like the bright orange red color for men that is not typical. There is a wide range of trousers available in the store. Most of them come in dark gray colors, but there are some lighter options too. They differ in fabrics and models. We can recommend Quechua NH 500 model for men. That is a relatively new line and can be used for different types of hiking. They have two zipped side pockets that are very handy and they come in grey and beige colors. The fabric is not the lightest though and not too stretchy, but in our opinion it is quite wearable and resistant. There is also a lighter model, Forclaz MT 100. And their advantage is that the fabric itself is easier to dry and wash, it also has the removable parts and is easy to tear into shorts. Overall, they feel very light and white, and so this option may suit people who value it the most. We wore those trousers on many hikes, and they proved to be a decent, durable model. For women, we like the Forclaz MT 500 model that is not the cheapest, but we find that the fabric is much more resistant than our other options. For example, we find that the very stretchy fabric quite fast becomes too loose after wearing and washing it several times. Forclaz MT 500, on the other hand, is not too stretchy, but just enough and very light and easy to move in. The fabric is not thin, so it holds the shape nicely. Overall, we find it a good price-quality ratio and my preferred model. If you prefer wearing leggings, there is a quite resistant trekking leggings Forclaz Travel 500. The fabric is quite thick on them, and I find that they are not very light on the leg, but do provide the necessary protection and won't lose the shape easily. You can move and climb in them with no problem. There are many useful pockets on them too.
And this video was made possible thanks to all our subscribers and new viewers who left the great feedback on our previous Decathlon beginner hiker gear list.
It made us realize that you want us to continue with this series, and we tried our best to follow up as soon as we could. So your response is our best motivation.
For the socks, we prefer two models, and they coincide both for men and women. It is Quechua Hike 50 and Quechua MH 100 as the budget option. And don't be deceived by the price, they're a nice sock that has a decent lifespan. Of course, it will all depend on how much distance you cover in them and how much weight you carry. But they have the denser, solid fabric in the feet and toe area that protects your feet and toes, prevents it from wiping. Socks for hiking should be thick enough to be able to withstand the extra weight and constant rubbing. The next layer would be the Quechua MH 500 line that is similar but offers even more protection to the feet and toes, with denser fabric, and they will serve you for longer. We prefer the medium height for the socks, short of course is not comfortable and long we find is excessive for us. Shoes is a very important topic, and to us it comes together with a comfortable backpack. Trail running shoes, from our personal experience, is the most convenient to hiking, and we prefer them over hiking boots. However, we found that for some reason many people still choose boots for long distance hiking. In our opinion, especially for the long distance, a shoe that is light, breathable, but at the same time durable and resistant to overloads comes a long way. We recommend the line from Evdic that's, again, in our opinion, is the best brand for the price-quality ratio. And from here it can be a very personal choice and a matter of trying out several models to find your best fit. But our recommendation can be Evdic TR model as a more budget option, and Evdic XT8 that offers even more comfort and grip, but at the same time more expensive. Both models offer a good sole and grip, they are rubberized and doesn't slip. It is very important that the sole is at the same time soft and non-slip. When you walk with weight and, for example, on a wet uneven trail, these shoes can protect your feet from accidental sprains or injuries. We also tested both of the models on long hikes and they proved to be the best. Nothing was torn anywhere, the sole doesn't wear out quickly, and they preserve the appearance and shape for a long time. We always bring with us a fleece shirt or sweatshirt even in the summer. We love them for their warmth and versatility, and they don't have to be expensive. Like the models Quechua SH100 and MH100. They dry very quickly and easy to wash, very warm, and don't add a lot of weight to your backpack. Sweatshirts are always needed, even when it may seem to you that it's too much and it won't be cold. Any storm or cold wind can come suddenly, it can be a quick change in the weather, cold rain, overnight in a tent in a damp place. The layer of warmth is very important out in the wild, and we recommend these models for both men and women. Another important piece of clothing are the fleece pants. We discovered this thing while hiking the Tour de Mont Blanc, where the nights may not be as welcoming temperature-wise as during the daytime. At night we are very comfortable sleeping in these fleece pants. They, like our fleece shirts, are very light, dry quickly, washing them will not be difficult for you. Everything is as practical and fast as possible, which is especially important when hiking. We recommend Wedze 100 thermal trousers, this is a very good solution. A waterproof jacket is indispensable in any trip. It will save you from strong winds and heavy rain. Taking a thicker wind and waterproof jacket will be more versatile when hiking in different conditions. It can also provide more isolation when needed. The models Quechua MH150 and MH500 for men, and Quechua MH100 for women is the best choice. They are similar in terms of fabric used and differ by design features and colors offered. As for durability, those models perform very well. They are resistant to rain and wind and do what they claim. We had to hike under heavy rain in them, everything got wet but not the jackets. Thus, jackets didn't allow the most important parts of the body to get wet and saved us from a cold. Of course, we would always recommend having a waterproof jacket or coat no matter what, but we just can't skip this fast hiking windbreaker jacket FH500, available both for men and women. We love it for how light it is and its design is great, but it is not waterproof. It will still provide some wind protection in the summer when walking in the hot or warm weather, when you don't need warmth, and it won't weigh you down, taking very little space in a backpack. Finally, there are several important accessories left. There are many summer hat options in Decathlon. We prefer using caps like this Forclaz Track 900. This light cap is not expensive, has very light fabric that you practically don't feel on the head, and at the same time it protects you from the pouring sun and sunstrokes. Besides, this cap is very wearable, we still have these caps from the very beginning of our hiking journey. And to this day, nothing has happened to them, although of course the material itself began to fade, but this didn't happen in 1 or 2 years. This model has also a removable neck cover that is attached to the cap by Velcro. It does provide an extra protection and it is nice, but we didn't like that the neck underneath starts to sweat a lot. It becomes unbearable hot. But we realized that it is a compromise, and if the sun is very strong, such as in the desert, then this becomes an inevitable measure. Sunglasses is also an important accessory on a hike, especially if you go in summer. There are quite a few different options in Decathlon. We like the model that is no longer on sale, but there is a similar one, also with UV protection and with excellent polarization like Quechua MH570. There are also differences in size, a smaller model may suit women like Quechua MH500, and you may choose your preferred lens color and level of polarization. We like Decathlon sunglasses for the price and quality. We have been wearing the same sunglasses for years in a row, and they have not worn down. They were repeated falls and the sunglasses didn't lose their appearance. They have sturdy frame and durable glass.
And this is all we wanted to share in this episode. We hope it will help you when shopping and making clothing and shoes choices for your first trip. It's very important to us to know if you like this series and found it helpful, and what you'd like to see in our next videos. Your feedback is crucial to us for better understanding what kind of content will bring the most value to you. Don't hesitate to leave it in the comments.
Don't forget to give this video a like to let us know it was useful to you. And we'd be happy if you join our YouTube family by subscribing to our channel. And if you really enjoyed our work, you can support us on our Ko-fi account. We'd appreciate every little support as it all goes back to the channel. And we'll see you all in our next episode very soon. Thank you for watching till the end. Bye.
Bye.